When you first log into the Wyze application, you're brought here. This is your home screen. If you have multiple Wyze devices, you will see them all listed here. In my case, I have lots and lots because I've been testing them out for a long time. Playlist up there in the corner if you're interested. So on the main screen, there are several things that we can do. We're going to concentrate on what we can do with the Wyze Cam Outdoor. So we're going to scroll down here, and our Wyze Cam Outdoor consists of two different parts. First being the base station and second being the outdoor camera. So to check our options for the base station, we click on that and we let it load. Here you can see the signal strength to the Wyze Cam Outdoor. In my case, it varies for me between 1 to 2. If we click on that, it brings us into the Wyze Cam, so we're not going to do that. We're going to click up here for the settings cog, and here we can change the name. We can check our micro SD card that's installed into the base station. We can format this, which means we erase it completely and start over. And down here we have eject SD card. So you can actually correctly eject the SD card without actually just pulling it out of the device. And by eject, I mean digitally eject like you would a USB drive from your computer. It doesn't automatically pop it out for you. Device info has lots of sensitive information, so we're not going to show you that. Travel mode, so this is one of the two places that you can access travel mode if you wanted to turn that on. We'll talk about travel mode a little later. And travel mode password. So right now, none set because I didn't use it, but there we go to change it. And we can delete the device if we wanted to. We're going to select back, brought back to our base station. We can add a Wyze Cam Outdoor from here, which we already have done, so we're not going to go through that again. But if I select Wyze Cam Outdoor, it brings me to the Wyze Cam Outdoor that I have set up with this particular base station. Remember, you can have up to 4 on a single base station. And we're just going to tap back to the main page again, because what you're going to see here, this outdoor camera is exactly where I got to going through the base station. From here, you can toggle on and off your camera. You can see its battery life. If it gets below 20%, this will show red and send you a notification, which is really nice. And that's an extra that they added after the fact. Selecting our outdoor camera will allow it to load up. Keep in mind that you can tilt your phone to have your image take up the entirety of the screen, but for what we're doing, we're just going to leave it like this so that we can see all of the options. In the upper left-hand corner there, you can see you have a toggle for HD. I can set this between HD, standard, 360, or auto. Depending on what your bandwidth is like, it will dynamically change whether it is standard or HD, and you don't have to do anything. Here you can see auto with a moon. What that means is it is on auto. I just changed it to night vision or night mode. I turned off night mode and I'm back to auto. So what that is you pretty much are toggling on the always daytime mode, always nighttime mode, or let the camera figure it out for itself. I recommend letting it figure it out for itself. Here you have your battery. So that is your battery indicator. On the big picture here, you can see what it sees. You can manually make it bigger by clicking that in the left-hand corner. You've got some things on here, Wyze, the date and time. Those are all things that we can adjust using the settings, but we'll touch on that in a moment. You can toggle your sound on and off. So that's the sound that you would hear from outside. You can start a recording. So if you see something there that you want to record, just tap record and it will automatically start recording it to the SD card for you. Speaker, tapping on that will allow you to start speaking and people on the other end can hear you. You can also take a picture, and there you go, you saw that little animation. It took a picture of what it was looking at right now. Under more, we have access to time lapse. Now, this is something I really like with the Wyze Cam Outdoor, and I really hope that they bring this feature to the rest of the Wyze products, because not only do you have custom, which is what every Wyze product has, they have some specifics. You can do sunrise, you can do sunset, flower blooming, or clouds. Each of these is a predefined setup. You don't have to manually do that. Because of that, you don't have to know how much time you need to set or the interval in which you need to set it up to get something like this. With all the other products, you really did have to know how to customize correctly to get rolling clouds. It saves it. And again, you will need an SD card in order for you to actually use this kind of feature. Now, the SD card has to be in the Wyze Cam Outdoor itself. It cannot be in the base station. You can have a copy of it in the base station, but the primary needs to be in the camera itself. So that was under more and time lapse. Scheduled recording is a way that will allow you to record an amount of time directly to your SD card. So if you want a 3-hour block recorded directly to your SD card, this is how you would do that. However, I will say it will kill the battery quite fast. And we're going to select back and more. I really wish it would bring you just back there. Albums, this will show you what it has. So in my case, it has photos. So there's a photo I just took. There's some, you know, a deer that was hanging out under my deck that I was trying to see. I've got videos, so there's lots of videos in here, especially from when I was testing it. But this is a folder for videos that you take, not things that are automatically saved to the SD card because of motion or person tracking. These are things that you have taken. And time lapse, there are my two time lapses of different clouds. And down here you can see there is a folder for scheduled recording. And one more time, we're going to select more. You have motion tagging. So if you want a person or motion to be tagged with a green box, that's how you would do it. And then we can turn this camera off right from here by selecting off. I wouldn't recommend doing that because, well, then your camera's not recording. We're going to close and come up here to the sprocket. This is the settings for our Wyze Cam Outdoor. Very similar to a lot of the other Wyze products, but we are going to select the toggle. We can name this. We can select event recordings, which gives us options. Detect motion, which we want. We want it to detect motion. Here is recording cooldown. So this is something unique to the Wyze Cam Outdoor. By default, all Wyze products have a 5-minute cooldown, meaning will not detect motion again for 5 minutes and then record. This one with the Wyze Cam Outdoor, we can do 5, 3, and 1. So I leave it at 1 so that I get as much as I can from outside. And then we can back up to the base station, which again, if you don't have an SD card in your base station, not gonna be as useful. Notifications, I have notifications pushed to the phone for sound, it heard something, person detection, all other motions. So if a leaf or a branch moved, I didn't want to get notified. I just wanted to get notified if it detected a person. Do keep in mind in the future, depending on when you're watching this, you probably will have to pay for person detection, but comparable to Ring or others out there, it shouldn't be as expensive. And then I also have a push notification for low battery, which is again, something they added a little later on via a software update. Detection settings. You have a slider for set distance and sensitivity. Now I have this going fairly far out and sensitivity being pretty high. The big thing that differentiates this from the indoor cameras, you can make a box with the indoor camera. This, because it uses the PIR sensor, which is just heat detection, you can notice at the bottom here, close to where all those sensors are, it's really green. As we progressively work our way up, it starts to fade out. Well, that's because it's not as effective further up away from the PIR sensor. Even if I change this, you'll notice that this here doesn't really change. Like even if I max this all the way out, you don't see that it really changes the grid down here much. It's just you telling it, hey, be this sensitive. I have mixed feelings about it because it has falsely triggered and not triggered on me in the past. So those were our detection settings. We're going to come into advanced. So in advanced, we can again turn off night mode, turn on night mode, or have it set to auto. We can turn off the IR lights, which could be useful depending on where you have this. It is a feature that Wyze added after the fact, and again, I greatly appreciate them doing that. Timestamp and watermark, so those things that you saw at the bottom of the video when I was bringing it up, that's what that is. You can rotate 180, so that's one of my favorite features with Wyze products. If the camera is situated thusly, but you need to mount it upside down, you can actually rotate the image 180 degrees so you can see things correctly. Show the Wyze logo. You don't have to, but that was that in the lower left-hand corner. Micro SD card. So if we click on that, it will show us how much space is on this card and then how much is on the base station. And again, we can format either or eject either. Schedule and automation. These are nifty things that Wyze does. I have a bunch of things set up for my cameras, for my lights, for my sensors. What this will allow you to do is set up a specific task. So in my case, my living room camera, I have it set up to turn on at midnight and turn off 6:30 a.m. before my wife or I are down in the living room. I then have it turn on again when we leave for work on those days. And then turn off right before we get home because I don't need it recording while my wife and I are home. You can do things similar to that using the Wyze Cam Outdoor. For me, I want it on recording all the time. But just know, if there's specific days and times that you don't want it to record, that's how you could do it. You can also set to if a sensor is triggered. So let's say you have Wyze sensors on your gate and the door opens, it can automatically trigger your Wyze Cam Outdoor to start recording. And I mean recording in that, you know, it will record what's going on, not just the 12-second motion clip. Sharing, if you have another person that you'd like to share this with, you can. They will need a Wyze account in order for you to be able to share that. Device info, again, lots of private information, not gonna show you that. Travel mode. So travel mode is something that is unique to the Wyze Cam Outdoor. It will allow the Wyze Cam to function as an independent device, meaning it doesn't have to be connected to the base station, which is connected to Wi-Fi. It will make its own Wi-Fi signal, which you can connect your phone to and interact with the Wyze Cam Outdoor that way. You will need a micro SD card in the camera itself, so don't think that you can do this without putting that SD card in there because, well, it's not going to record anything because it is not connected to the base station, which is how you would get those cloud clips. If you are using this in travel mode, everything is being recorded to the SD card, so you will not have a cloud backup. Keep that in mind. So you can select don't show me this, or you can continue. I'm not going to continue because I'm not going to go through the setup process with you. But here we can see travel mode password. So if you didn't set that up before, this is how you can set it up. And then here, they even have a little user manual that you can get into. Mounting guide, status lights guide. So if we click on these will actually show us, hey, what does this stuff mean? So they are building in this support and help right into the app to make your life much simpler. That brings us back to the main page. So let's go back one more time, because if this is the first Wyze product that you're looking at, you might not know what these at the bottom are. Well, right now we're on home because that is our home page. Up here, this is a quick area for edit devices, which means I can rearrange these. I can edit rules or create rules, or in my case, I'm just gonna select done. Here we have notifications, snooze or no, add a rule. So that same rule page that we were on before, we can add something right here. Along the bottom, we come across to events. This will grab all of your events from all of your Wyze cameras and put them in one place. You can select, I just want to see things that have person tagged in them, or motion, or I can specify a camera that I want. So this has become very useful as they've been editing and changing things. And again, we can filter, which is what we were doing before with the cameras, cancel, and we can edit, which is select devices. So if I go like that, I can select them. All right, down here, discovery. This has changed. This used to be, hey, check out these cool people's Wyze Cams and what they've been doing with them. It has kind of turned into a promotional area as well as a information hub, almost like a blog right from Wyze themselves. Shop, that's built into the app now too. Hey, did you know that the Wyze company is coming out with headphones and a doorbell and a thermostat? Well, this is where you'd find that information as well as anything else Wyze sells. Last but not least is your account information. Up at the top, it will let you know if you're a Cam Plus member and what your subscription looks like. You also have access to your services. In my case, I'm still part of the person detection demo and emergency button pilot. Clicking on these will let you know, hey, what's actually utilizing them. So if you pay for person detection, you will have to turn it on for each of your cameras. So this is kind of where you'd come to do that. We're gonna go back. Security. Change your password, two-step verification or 2FA, highly recommend doing that. Sharing, again, another place that will allow you to share your Wyze Cams. Notifications, again, this will bring all of your cameras in one place and then you can select on something and check what you want to actually notify you with. Firmware upgrade, if you want to upgrade all your cameras firmware and all your devices firmware, let's be honest, in one place, this is where you can do it. So here you can see my living room, my workshop, and my garage all have a firmware upgrade that I should be doing, but I'm filming right now, so I won't be doing that. Works with, right now, I have it set to work with my Amazon Echo devices. Rule history, this shows you pretty much what has happened. If you set up rules, well, it wants to show you what all those rules have triggered. So I have something that turns on and off my basement. That's the primary one that you're gonna see, especially now when I'm home and doing things around the house. But that's what rule history is. Order history as well, what have you purchased from Wyze? In my case, you can see I pre-ordered the doorbell, I got some masks. That's my Wyze Sense, that's the Wyze Band. You get the idea. Help and feedback. Just that, select your device, and just like for the Wyze Cam Outdoor, you'll be brought to helpful articles and feedback areas. App settings. Well, here it's showing cache and then hardware decoder, so we're just gonna leave that alone. And about. So here you go, terms of service, privacy statement, and user license agreement or EULA, and open source software. So in case you didn't know what those at the bottom brought you to, that's what it is. Up here in the corner is our messages, so if you happen to have shared a device, so here we go, shop, device sharing, all those little message notifications will end up there. So we're gonna come back home and click on our outdoor camera one more time so you can see just how long I've been doing this, because it's probably dark outside now.